Hi all, I'm Ankur Gupta. Hope all of you are doing well and welcome to Analytics School. Today, we are going to discuss about who is a data analyst and what does a data analyst do. But before we start our discussion, let's go through a few of the quotes. Half the money I spend on advertising is wasted. The trouble is, I do not know which half. We are surrounded by data, but starved for insights. Without big data analytics, companies are blind and deaf, wandering out onto the web like a deer on a freeway. By going through this quote, you understand that all the companies, they look for some sort of the research so that they can make business decisions. So who is a data analyst? A data analyst is the one who gathers, clean, manipulate, and interprets data in order to solve a business problem and enables the organization and stakeholders to make more informed decisions. Organizations in all industries increasingly rely on data to make critical business decisions, such as new products to develop, new markets to enter, new investment to make, or to target customers. They also use data to identify inefficiencies and other business problems that needs to be addressed. So, should you become a data analyst? Roles such as data analysts are in high demand. It has been estimated that there will be more than 2.5 million jobs for professionals with data skills by 2025, with nearly 40% of them are going to be in advanced analytics. Entry-level data analysts can expect a base salary of $75,000 in US, plus other benefits. Senior data analysts in US can expect a base pay of 120K plus benefits. If the role of a data analyst sounds like a good fit for you, here is what you need to know. Generally, data analysts do these tasks on daily basis. They are collaborating with others. Being able to communicate well is important, and your success is dependent on your ability to work with people. The people you are gathering the research question from, peers you collaborate with to execute the work, and the people you deliver the findings. Gathering data. Data analysts often collect data themselves. This can be quantitative data or qualitative data. Data cleaning. Freshly collected data will usually be in a raw format. This means that it has yet to be organized, checked for errors, and so on. To get into a state that's suitable for analysis, the data needs cleaning. Data cleaning tasks include removing errors, duplicates, outliers, eradicating unwanted data, structure the data in a more useful way, and so on. The process of collecting and cleaning data is also known as data wrangling. Now the fun part comes in, analyzing the data. Once your data is clean and tidy, you are good to analyze. By manipulating the data using various data analysis tools and techniques, one can begin to find trends, correlations, outliers, and variations that begin to tell a story. During this stage, you might use data mining to discover patterns by using programming languages such as Python or R, or data visualization tools such as Tableau to help transform our data into an easy to understand. And in this particular way, you can connect all the dots and tell your story. Presenting your finding is very critical for data analysts. Communicating the results of your findings will be a key part of a data analyst job. Data analysts do this by putting together visualization like charts and graphs, writing reports, and presenting information to stakeholders. So what tools do data analysts use? There are a variety of data sources. It can be, and it can be saved into various formats like Excel, CSV file, data coming from the relational databases such as Microsoft SQL Server or in big data. For example, you have to use Hive and Spark to extract the data. Tableau and Power BI are two data visualization tools, which one of them at least a data analyst should know to present your finding to the stakeholders. Data analysts should also know one of the programming languages such as Python, R, or SAS to manipulate the data, to build up the data visualizations, for example, bar chart or line charts and whatnot, to connect all the dots and then you have to present your finding to the stakeholders. For doing all these programming languages, you might be using some sort of IDE, or for example, what Visual Studio Code or Jupyter Notebooks. And most of the companies are using Git and GitHub to so that you can easily share your analysis with other data analysts or data scientists, so that they can also get benefited. And they do not need to do the duplicate work, since you have done the analysis, and they can use that particular analysis in their future work. So what are the skill sets needed for a data analyst? One should have moderate math and statistical skills, a strong business acumen, have moderate coding skills. One should know how to develop KPIs, create visualization of the data, and they should know how to use business intelligence tools such as Tableau or Power BI, because in this particular way, you can do your work faster and complete your task in stipulated time frame. It is not mandatory, but if you know it, it is more valuable for you. So in this session, we have covered everything you need to know if you are starting in data analytics. We have explored what a data analyst does and what skills they need and the tools that a data analyst should aim to learn. In the next session, we will discuss about the objective of this whole course, what you are going to learn, and how this course will help you to become a proficient data analyst. Thank you so much.